Om Namah Shiva students. Students, in today's class of mass media, we will begin with the fourth chapter from your unit 2, Evolution of Media, the print media and its type. So student, first we must know what is print media. Students, print media are traditional mass media published on paper. The concept not only includes the published products but also regards the organizational context shaping the journalistic routines and norms behind the printed products. Now, print media represents the oldest and the most widespread type of mass media because, as opposed to electronic media, that means the digital media that we have today, it does not require an elaborate technical infrastructure on the part of the user. It does not require. That's why it is one of the most popular print media. It is one of the most popular mass media among people. And it mainly comprises of newspapers and magazines. Now students, coming, when this print media actually came into existence, what we have learned, what we have seen, that printing is a process for mass reproducing text and images using a master form of or template. That means one main production is there, one master copy is there, and from there millions, a lot many copies can be produced. And the machine which will be producing that is all the printing machine. Now the earliest non-paper products involving printing include cylinder seals and objects such as the Cyrus cylinder and the cylinder of Nemonides. Okay, and the earliest known form of printing as applied to paper was woodblock printing. What is it? Woodblock printing, which appeared in China before 202 AD, that means Anno Domini, for cloth printing. So the earliest form of printing was actually there for the cloth printing. Now it would not be applied to paper, and until when? Until the 7th century. Got it? Later developments in printing technology also came into existence, and the movable type was invented, and a movable type was invented, and the printing press was invented by Johannes Gutenberg in the 15th of century. Now students, this invention or the technology of printing played a key role in the development of the Renaissance and the scientific revolution, and laid the material basis for the modern knowledge based economy and the spread of learning to the masses. Until and unless that, whatever education was there, it was not spread to the masses. So there was a medium required through which they could spread it through the masses. That's why, that means from one master copy, millions of copies, a lot many copies were needed. And until and unless this printing media was there in existence, this was not possible. So printing media was definitely a revolution. Okay, definitely played a revolution in the key role. Now students, this print media mainly comprises of newspapers and magazines. Now newspapers are clearly associated with information and show an emphasis on political issues and current events, and they are valued as a backbone of the democratic public sphere because they enable comprehensive public discourse. Okay, and news magazines also serve an information function, whereas most other magazines are more committed to entertainment and leisure. Though magazines also play in doing something innovative or sharing some knowledge, but it is mainly related to entertainment and leisure. These magazines show a diverse spectrum ranging from lifestyle to special interest magazine. With the rise of online communication nowadays, print newspapers and magazines have come under considerable economic pressure. Okay, so by the late 17th century, newspapers and periodicals actually came to be published on a regular basis in the countries of Europe. And this is the main thing. And the people who got engaged with this, newspapers and periodicals, are called the journalists. And the profession they practiced is called journalism. Now students, we will see what is news. Okay, what is news? Now, the nature of journalism and one's approach to what journalism is therefore depends on one's perspective of news and news values. That means what they want to bring to the audience, what they want to bring to the readers. That is the news. So we can say the news is the account of an event, not something intrinsic in the event itself. It is the documentation of the event. Hence, news is a written, audio or visual construction of an event of happening or person. News is not happening. News is a written form of what is happening. Clear? Now, there is nothing in the event itself and that is making the news. The event is not the news. Make it understand that, okay? The event is not the news. Okay, there is nothing in the event itself. Rather, the news is the write-up or the audio or visual presentation of the event. Understood? So, further, such a presentation or representation or construction of an event has to be in a particular format and selected according to a certain professional value system to make it news. Definitely, whatever is happening and if you are documenting that, it is not going to be news. Some ethics or some rules has to be followed so that it can be sorted out as news. So it needs to be emphasized that news is the end product of a complex process which begins with a systematic sorting and selecting of events according to a socially constructed set of categories. That means certainly there were certain categories which were divided. These are the categories that has been classified. Now certain things are happening and certain things are falling into certain categories of news. Definitely all happenings will not fall in same categories of news. They are divided, they are subdivided and they are forming different news. So it is not the event which is reported that determines the form, content, meaning or truth of the news, but rather the news that determines what is that event means. So the event is not becoming important. When it is becoming news, then it is becoming important. Understood? Now the meaning results from the cultural discourse that news employs. And as social linguist puts, news is a social institution and a cultural discourse which exists and has meaning only in relation to other institutions and discourses operation at the same time. Now, like languages, news is a map, we can say, not the terrain on which the map represents. A map uses codes, conventions, sign and symbol which have to be read or actively interpreted. So does news also. News, as it were, maps the world. News selects and processes and produces and shapes an event or happening. News is bringing you together. Okay. Now, coming to the mainstream journalism. Mainstream journalism treats news as a commodity product, okay, to be bought and sold in the marketplace of information. Now, definitely the journalists who are there, who are working at the editorial house, the more crucial or the more informative news they collect, accordingly they are also leveled at that class of journalist. Understanding, you know what I'm trying to say? That means the category of news they are collecting, if they are endangering their lives to collect some news, to gather some information, definitely they are ranked higher than one who are going on recording some casual news. So this is how the business of journalism also, or mainstream journalism also, is going on. Actually, the focus is on the exceptional and the elitist, and the preferred format is the inverted pyramid news report. Other formats include features, editorials, columns, opinion pieces. So what is happening? What you are collecting, what is the most important thing? That is, if you are able to gather that, if you are able to bring that forward, then it is becoming the most important news. Clear? Now we will be seeing analyzing newspapers and their content. Now journalists work for the broadsheet or quality or series, serious press, and the tabloid or popular or sensational press. Now the term broadsheet and tabloid or compact usually describe the two main formats of newspaper. Very important, students. But the levels also connote two kinds of news stories selected, and more importantly the presentation, treatment and style as well. However, this distinction is now blurred, especially when the serious or quality papers such as the Times of India, the Indian Express and the Asian Age choose to highlight the private lives of public figure and the tabloids. Initially, these types of news were not there in the mainstream news, but nowadays these are also coming along with the mainstream newspapers. Okay, initially this midday, the afternoon dispatch and courier and today, all these things used to publish investigate stories of corruption in high place. And the third format is termed as the Berliner. Okay, third format is the Berliner. Berliner, which is popular with European and some North American daily newspapers. So these are the different kinds of newspapers and their content, what they are publishing. Now we are coming to tabloid journalism, which is frequently termed as yellow journalism, primarily because of its tendency to sensationalize and trivialize events, issues and people. The staple of the tabloid, that means the main content of the tabloids, is the private lives of famous people's crime, accident, disasters and etc. That means they are not focusing on any accident, they are not focusing on any other important happening. They are only focusing on the private lives of famous people so that they can form a chit chat among the people. Now students, tabloid journalists are believed to indulge in checkbook journalism, which implies that the subjects of the news stories are bribed to sell their true confessions. Actually, they are imbibing so that they can bring out the true confessions and from there they can earn their money. Such journalists are also believed to indulge in keyhole journalism or sting journalism. Isn't it sting journalism? Because all those things they have to do very carefully. They cannot do in open light. They have to be very careful. Even we can say they have to do that in a disguise. Okay, in their attempts to probe the private lives of the people. Then there is page 3 also, journalism, another very important topic, which focuses on the social lives of celebrities and film stars and sports heroes. Social lives, how they are living their lives apart from their professional factor. So these journalists practice raise several ethical questions about the invasion of the privacy of individuals and the public's right to information. In most democracies, reasonable restrictions are imposed on these instructions on privacy, especially if they are not in the way related to the public interest. So if they are violating the rules rather than keeping in mind the public interest, then they are not allowed. So along with this comes the tabloid television also, which follows the same pattern of selection, treatment and the style of the tabloid press. In the pre-satellite television era, that is the 1980s, when satellite was not in existence, the video, news magazines, news track and eyewitness were in the tabloid tradition. In recent years, India TV, Janmat, Now Live India and the crime-based programs on several television news channels verge on the sensational and the tabloid. Understood? Now with this we completed the chapter. Now here are a few activities which are you supposed to do. With this we completed the chapter, print media. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.